Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a haul for you guys. If you are interested in this look right here, it should already be up in my channel. And I've been out with the flu for 7 days, guys. This flu like wiped me out. And as you guys know, I'm pregnant. So I was very limited to what I could take. And then what they prescribed me took forever to actually work. Like even after I started taking it, it was like 3 to 4 days before I actually started to feel like I was finally starting to feel better. So it's been a little rough, but I am doing great. My little nugget is doing great, and he'll be 7 months this Friday. So I'm gonna show you guys just some goodies that I got while I was dying on my couch. So the first thing I want to talk to you guys about is the Chanel Universal Libre. It's their setting powder. And I got it in the shade 30. It's what I have on now. It's got like a little bit of a beigey, peachy coloring to it, as you guys can see. And I've used it with the sponge. It came with a really nice Chanel sponge. And for the cost, it better have, right? There is, let's see, 1 ounce in this bad boy. And I will tell you guys that today I actually used it with my standard MAC 133 brush. And I think I like it better than the Powder Puff. I feel like the Powder Puff just deposits a little bit too much product. So, yeah, that's what it looks like. Can you guys tell I've become a little bit of a setting powder whore? Yeah, I have. All right. The next thing I picked up was, I actually got a new Tan de Soleil, or Soleil Tan de Chanel bronzer. Let me see if I can show you guys mine. This stuff, no, I think I actually threw it out because I'm done with it. I literally, this bronzer will last you forever. It's a cream to powder finish. I'm not going to remove it, but that's basically what it looks like. It's just really beautiful, light, natural looking, and I really love this stuff. If you store it upside down, again, this is going to last you a lot longer than if you let the oil actually travel to the bottom of your product. This stuff is amazing. I love it. It's one of my favorite bronzers, and I had mine for about 2 years. And again, I've always sorted upside down, so it was still going strong. I just literally was scraping the edges just to get the rest of it off. So love this stuff. Okay, I'm gonna quickly show you guys something that I picked up at the drugstore. I got the L'Oreal Blend Artist Infallible. This is what it looks like. I actually use this on this look. And let me tell you guys, I'm very impressed with this sponge. It's so soft. And it did a beautiful job applying my foundation. And I think that if, you know, a beauty blender isn't something that you can easily access, this was, I want to say, $7. And it does just as good of a job as a beauty blender. The only thing I will tell you is a beauty blender is slightly more pointed. And I feel like you can get into your under eyes better than with this guy. I really had to like pinch it to really get into that inner corner. But other than that, this is totally worth the hype and the money. And when I found it, I bought mine at Walmart. So I think it was like $6.99. And this guy was the last one. So I grabbed it and it's absolutely amazing. So I highly recommend this one. And I've tried the Real Techniques sponge, and I will tell you I like this one more. So if that means anything to you guys. All right, guys, I picked up 2 new brushes from Sephora. And this is the Sephora, what is this? Pro Core Diffuser Angled 95 brush. This is what it looks like. And this one's actually meant for contouring. I'm actually going to try this one out with my Chanel bronzer. But from the minute I saw them, I'm like, these look like really good brushes. And they're really soft and dense. And I feel like it's going to do a beautiful job with applying makeup. And then I also got the number 94 And this one is the Core Diffuser Dome. Diffuser, whatever. And this one's rounded, whereas a 95 is slanted. This one is round and flat. And I think this one would be good for foundation or maybe just doing a light dusting of powder. But again, I saw these and I'm like, I need those in my life. I picked up the Kevyn Aucoin Celestial Bronzing Veil in Tropical Nights. It's actually what I have on today as a contour. This is what it looks like. And as you guys can see, the bronzer is not so much of a bronzer. It's more of a cool tone contour shade. And then it blends down into this like grayish highlight. I really just kind of swirl it all together and then apply it to my cheeks. I would not use this as a bronzer. I feel like it would be too muddy. And they have Tropical Days, which seemed like it'd be a little too orangey for my liking, my complexion. So I decided that this one was the one that would be best for me. So like it. Okay, so I picked up some random items. I picked up some brushes from Verb, which is a line that we carry at Sephora. I got this guy here, which is, I forget what they call this, but it's like your blow drying brush. And then I got a standard round brush. This one is ceramic, I guess like the center is ceramic, so it's supposed to like be better as you're blow drying your hair. But really, I needed new brushes. Like mine are just a mess. And when I saw these, I'm like, oh, let's give these a shot, you know? This one feels really good as you're brushing your hair. Like, it feels like it's a little massage to your hair or your head. And this one I haven't tried yet. So these guys are new. I picked up two of the Marc Jacobs highliners. And I got Fine Wine and Brownie. I used Brownie in my tutorial. And let me show you guys what that looks like. So the packaging on these is different because they're matte. Whereas the other ones were like a high shine metallic finish. It doesn't mean anything about the actual product itself, but let me show you Brownie. They're still very smooth and pigmented. They set and don't budge. And then this is Fine Wine. This one is like, whoa. I've used them both already and they're amazing liners. Once these guys set, they don't move, so they're phenomenal. I got some samples. I got this Urban Decay liquid liner sample in Perversion and a little mascara from MAC. So some of the my Chanel products were from Nordstrom, so they sent me these. And then the rest of the items are all Sephora with the exception of the blender or the, ¿cómo se llama? The sponge. I swear my little nugget is eating my brain. I feel like my grammar, my spelling have like significantly changed. I find myself struggling with words I never struggled with. It's the weirdest thing. I know it sounds crazy. If any of you guys have ever experienced that, please let me know because I really feel like, is this really happening? Anyway, I picked up two fragrances. They're both by Derek Lamb. I have always wanted these, but they were expensive, and I'm like, no. And I almost bought one, which was the biggest size. I can't remember what it was. But I figured that for the price of one big one, I can get two of the mini ones, and that's exactly what I did. As I've mentioned, my nose has become extra sensitive, and I can't tolerate a lot of the fragrances that I have been accustomed to wearing. So these guys, I can. This is Drunk on Youth. And this one I got in a little sample. I have another sample somewhere. And I have been wearing the sample like nonstop. And my husband really liked it. So I was like, if he really likes it, then I'm gonna wear it. And it's been a while since he's actually really loved a fragrance that I wear. Like, he'll like them, but not like when we first started dating. There was one perfume that I would wear all the time and he loved it. And he was like, find something like that, you know? And I just haven't been able to find anything like that. But this he really liked, the Drunk on Youth. And they're both really clean scents. I feel like Drunk on Youth is a little bit more floral, but it's a soft floral. You can still pick up more of the cleaner notes than you can the actual floral scent in this. And then the second one I got was Rainy Day, I think it's called, or Rain Day? Rain Day. And this one I've always liked. It smells amazing. It's a little bit masculine. And I don't care. Like, I like a masculine scent. I like that really clean, fresh. Like, I can honestly see my husband wearing this. He doesn't have a problem with me wearing this. He's never said, like, oh, that smells like a man, or, you know, that hasn't said anything. I think his favorite of the two would be the Drunk on Youth. But they are both really light, clean scents. This is more like your fresh, out of the shower kind of scent. Whereas this one is a little bit more of like your intentional scent. I love it. I love both of them. I have no regrets. And the bottles are cute, but the fragrances are amazing. So those two are my favorite by far. All right, so I picked up Sephora, what is this? Luster Matte Longwear Lip Color in the color Fig Luster. And this one I've always had my eye on because one of our managers at Sephora always mixes this one with one of the Sephora liquid lip stains in the nude one. I can't remember what it's called. But she looks so gorgeous in it, and I've always wanted it and always forget to get it. But it was on sale on the website. That's what the color looks like. And I picked it up, and it's just a really pretty mauve-y pink shade. But let me tell you, Ashi makes this. What is the other color? Marvelous Mauve. This and Marvelous Mauve combined look like very sex kitten. It's so pretty. And every time I see it on her, I'm like, I know what she's wearing because I've asked her a million times. And they're just beautiful. So I figured I needed this in my life. And it was on sale, so why not? I picked up, so my bronzer, and I got a highlighter, a new highlighter. Let me show you guys. So my bronzer, my Kevyn Aucoin bronzer, this thing and these two I actually bought off of the website. And I got the Volume Mascara. And geez, this packaging is no joke. I can't open it. Wait. Let me see. There we go. Just got the little tiny one. This one is supposedly Kim Kardashian's go-to mascara. And I really liked it because it's small, and I'm like, oh, it would be nice to try something different on the lash line, the lower lash line. Typically, I wear my MAC Extended Play Giga Black lash. So I got this one. I'm not gonna open it for yet because I'm not ready to use them. I'm gonna like literally go through my mascaras that I'm using now. And then I got the full size of the Essential Mascara, which I used my mini one. Let me show you guys what that looks like. This is what the packaging looks like on the big one. And I really loved the sample. I got a little mini sample. Where did I get this one? I think I got it. Oh, I got it when I placed my first order at Kevyn Aucoin. They sent it. So they got me, guys. It's a bent wand, and it's the kind of wand I like. I like this really like fluffy, fat wand. It does a beautiful job at giving you length and fullness without being clumpy. And I really like the actual brush because I feel like it holds my lashes up. I have really straight snuffleupagus lashes, and I feel like this mascara, even if I don't curl my lashes, will still do a nice job at actually like pulling them up. So I really, really, really like it. And they got me. So when I placed my second order, I actually got the full size mascara. And the first order I placed was to get the Neo highlighter. That's what the box looks like. The packaging is very pretty. It's always like, I like the gold. It's not like obnoxious. It's just a really pretty soft gold. I know it sounds so stupid. But I do like it. And it comes in this little sleeve. Let me show you guys. And again, the Kevyn Aucoin packaging is just beautiful. It's classic, it never changes. And that's what the highlighter looks like. And it's got this big mirror on the bottom. I'm gonna apply some of this. Look at that highlight. And I'm literally, all I'm doing is just mixing the three. It's so pretty. It's just a very subtle highlight, but I feel like you can definitely get it to pop. So there it is. Very happy. It's really pretty. It's humongous. Let's see how much is in here. It's not even an ounce, but they get you with the packaging. They make you feel like you're getting a ton when really it's not even an ounce. It's 0.74 ounces, but it's still a lot of product. So I really like this and I would recommend it to you guys because it is amazing. I got some samples. I got the Replica Beach Walk. I actually smelled this already. And I think I'm gonna like this one. It smells really beachy and clean. I got another one of the Drunk on Youth samples by Derek Lamb. I got this Lighted Up Celestial Skin Liquid Lightening. It's in the shade Candlelight, so I'm assuming it looks like it's a product that you would apply on the skin before your foundation, so I got a sample of that. I also got the Shiseido Ultimune Power Infusing Concentrate. I'm not really sure what this is for, but I got a sample. And I got the Sephora Fond de Teint Perfection 10-Hour Wear Foundation. And I used it already. I tried the top one, which is shade number 33. That was a little too dark for me. And then I went in with medium 25, which is the middle shade, and it was a perfect match. So I was actually really impressed with this foundation. I hadn't ever tried it, but I also know that some of the girls at work really love it. So I'm not surprised that I liked it as much as I did. I renewed my VIB Rouge status for this year already. And this year what they gave is one of their brushes. And I got the, let's see here. It doesn't say what it is. Pro Mini Flawless Airbrush. It's number 56 and a half because it's a little baby one. And it's red, of course, VIB Rouge. And it comes with this little sleeve. It also came in a little fancy pouch, which I don't really care for. I have too much, too many little bags already. But this I thought was cute because I could travel with this or just kind of throw it in my purse. And let's see what else. I don't know where I got this from. It's Organic Flowers Eye Essence. Whatever. And then I got a Nest Black Tulip perfume. I actually just bought this for my best friend for her birthday. And I love the scent. It's really pretty. I loved it a lot. And I was tempted to get it for myself also, but I decided not to because I had just purchased two new fragrances. I practiced self-control, guys. Yes, I did. I practiced self-control. I bought this Sephora, what is this? It's a pencil. It's one of their eyeshadow pencils. And I got it in beige glitter. I've always seen these at work and I've always liked them. I don't know why I never picked one up, but this one's the one that always catches my eye. It's right there. So pretty and sparkly, and I've already played with this and I absolutely love it. Just a few more things and then I promise we're done. I got another Nude Stix pencil in burgundy, and let me show you guys what this looks like. These come with a little mirror at the end. It comes with this little pamphlet thingamajiggy that I'm going to throw out. and then a sharpener for your lip product. So I thought that was pretty cool. The shade I got, like I said, is burgundy. I've already worn this. And this I feel like is a great everyday burgundy berry shade. I have Greystone, which is like a brown gray tone, and I feel like I can't wear that every day to work, clearly. But this I could see myself wearing quite a bit. And again, it's in this little tin. I will tell you guys that I feel like the mirror is not something that I absolutely love. I feel like it's unnecessary, and I feel like we're paying for a product to have a mirror to come in a tin, but the reality is, how many of us are actually gonna carry this in our purses or make it a point to travel with a little tin? Like, it doesn't appeal to me. I would rather them, you know, provide us with a standard carton package and the sharpener and charge us less than for these little tins, because I don't see myself holding on to these tins, and it's a waste. You know, there's a mirror, a nice big mirror, but I feel like it is a waste. Or at least give us the option to purchase the tin or chuck it, you know? I don't know. Saves a few bucks, nude sticks. All right, can I just show you guys this? This was a birthday gift from one of my little buddies. She's actually one of the managers at Sephora, and I love this little bag. It's just so cute, and that's where I had all my goodies. But I love seeing it. It's so beautiful and gold, and I love it. Anyway, I bought the Tarte Man Eater palette. The packaging is so cute, but that's not why I got it. Again, me and my stupid little films. Gonna get rid of that. It comes with a mirror. It's a nice size mirror. And then these colors. They're just these really beautiful, warm, reddish pink tones. You get four mattes, four shimmers. This jumbo color is a highlight shade that I'm assuming can be worn on the face or all over. But I just thought this was a really good palette to have just for like everyday use. It's very quick and easy. All right, guys, so that is the final haul. I actually have two other things coming. I bought a blue Marc Jacobs liner, like a royal blue. I forget what it's called. And it's part of the new colors that they've added. And then I also bought a purple mascara from Sephora. The blue one I want, but I still have some of my YSL mascara and I couldn't justify it. So once I go through that, it's nice to know that the Sephora collection is amazing and it's super pigmented. So just so you guys know, it's $10 and it's available online and in store. Head over and check it out if you like colored mascaras but don't really want to commit to like a really expensive mascara. All right, that's all I have for you guys. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.